rise for our invocation, and please remain standing for our Philippine National Anthem and the DOST hymn. And exhibits. It has been a fruitful two-day event for all of us here at Marriott Hotel, with all the presentations and exhibits that we were able to witness yesterday and the other day. To formally open our program, let me call in the Regional Director of the Department of Science and Technology Region 7, Engineer Edelberto L. Paradella.
Former director, Then, Evangeline Evangelista, CITO. So, my friend, my good friend, and then University of San Jose Recoletos, Dr. Aguilena, to the Science and Technology Information Institute headed by BOM. Thank you for your support on this program, as well as the media partners from the national and the local. This AA has brought, I think, about 4 media personnel just to cover our activity in Central Visayas. This activity is known as what we call the Science Mission Tour. Our team in this activity is, kung Tagalog, it's agham random na, no? Kung Bisaya na, o kung Bisaya na to, science, na-fail na to, kung sa pag nga, murag nakita na to, the importance of science, no? In the way we do our activity, no? Coming up with the innovation. So, wag na ang atong intention karon. And one of the component is the regional invention contest and exhibit. And I'm very happy in this activity. No, I'm really supporting this endeavor. I was hired in 1985, no? To work with the inventors and to promote the regional inventors contest. During the time with Director Almase, we have a very limited entry, no? And if you're going to look on the contents, this is a kayo nindot, no? Unlike today, the innovations, the inventions, the creativity are really addressing what the community needs, no? Or the need of the country. Like, for example, an invention, and there are also some entry in relation of coming up with a temporary shelter, no? I'm not sure if you're familiar with our problem now, or we have what we call a new normal. New normal in terms of hydrometeorological hazard, new normal in terms of geologic hazard. No? So talking about hydrometeorological hazard, so you can expect typhoon higher than 350 kph per hour. No? So there's really need to address that. Then, a geologic hazard from a magnitude 4 to 6 earthquake, maybe it could be 9 or 7.2. The question is, are we ready, no? Because Cebu is also vulnerable. There are plenty of faults, no? within your vicinity, and it's also nice to know it so that we can be prepared. So, to our participants, as well as to the advisors and the individual innovators and inventors, we really recognize what you have done, no? on the potential impact on your endeavor, as well as we encourage you to continue your innovation even without the regional inventors contest. No? So try to look on the needs of the community, and being an inventors and innovators and researchers, maybe we can work together in addressing some problem. Thank you and good day to everyone.
Thank you very much, Engineer Paradella. At this part, ladies and gentlemen, we will be distributing the certificates of appreciation to our 42 entries. So allow me to call in the different entries for our regional invention contest and exhibits. Let me read first the citation before we will be giving the certificates. The Department of Science and Technology, Regional Office Number 7, together with the Technology Application and Promotion Institute, award this certificate of participation to the entry title during the 2015 DOST-7 Regional Invention Contest and Exhibit on June 18 to 20, 2015, Cebu City Marriott Hotel, given this 20th day of June 2015 at Cebu City Marriott Hotel, Cebu, signed by Engineer Edilberto L. Paradella, Regional Director of DOST-7, and Engineer Edgar I. Garcia, the Director of Technology Application and Promotion Institute. So for the first category, we have from for Cebu Award, Outstanding Student Creative Research for High School. Our first entry with the title Sound Absorber Board for Noise Control Using Coconut Fire Mixed with Sodium Silicate Binder. Our second entry, Coconut Spath Fiber-Based Media as Biofilter for Air Pollution. Our third entry, Human Locomotion Vibra or Vibrational Energy Harvester Prototype for Powering Light Emitting Diode. And our fourth is Fabrication and Characterization of Nanospheres Manganese Oxide Doped Zinc Oxide Films via Sedimentation, Deposition, Evaporation, and Sintering Technique for Rainwater Treatment. Let me call in any representative from the group. And let me request also Engineer Paradella, Engineer Garcia, Mr. D, Engineer Zamora, and Mr. Espelita to award the certificates to our representatives. Okay, for our next entry, application of green synthesized nanoparticles to cotton fabric and its antibacterial activity against Staphylococcus aureus. Fabrication and characterization of photocatalytic paper from yucca filamentosa fibers coated with zinc oxide nanoparticles. Synthesis of polyurethane from coconut oil. And morphological characteristics of microbes with potential oil degrading ability. For our outstanding student creative research college category, we have optimized solar collector and tracker with planar reflector, composite board from mango husk waste, remote solar powered rainfall monitoring and alarm system, and drying of banana, Musa acuminata, pseudostem paper in a compartment tray dryer of Cebu Institute of Technology University. We also have amphibious tricycle, in vitro assessment of the antibacterial effect of combined lemongrass and garlic extracts on methicillin-resistant Staphylococcus aureus, Young's module of elasticity of some wood samples taken from Amblan and Ciato negros oriental, and climate change in Dumaguete City. For our LICA, Outstanding Creative Research, GX3 Garnet, the original hand painting multiplier device. We have MAIL 68, the closed loop powdering machine with unique gravity reparator. Kamomo cylinderless pneumatic press. Fats, oil, and grease separator. We also have Bangkaya, isolation treatment system, isobaring, method of preparing texturized keseo, method of producing pandan scented coconut charcoal deodorizer or freshener. We also have method of preparing of jackfruit, Artocarpus heterophyllus seed candy. The method of preparing drop cookie enriched with kangkong, Ipomea aquatica, power booster and fuel saver device, an emergency and post-disaster shelter, bamboo structure, chapel of the lake. We also have the emergency shelter, PVC and bamboo arc frame structure, impenetrable multiple super shelter, production of foliar fertilizer from fish processing waste, and the folding boat. Thank you. would like to acknowledge the presence of Cebu Chamber of Commerce President Ms. Teresa Chan. Please join us on stage, ma'am. For our outstanding utility model, we have process and composition in the production of milk fish, Chanos bone meal, composition of milk fish, Chanos bone spread, flavored fish sauce, composition of liquid hand wash, calcium-enriched gluten-free cookies, method and composition of preparing draw ink from squid, Physanotheophis rhombus pigment, composition of gluten-free flour blends and compact diesel brewer. Outstanding invention category, Mammoth coffee table, Radica panels, and planter. And for the outstanding industrial design, we have the Theo cocktail table. That was a total of 42 entries, ladies and gentlemen, and we are hoping for more entries. A big hand, please, ladies and gentlemen. So we will be having our next RISE in 2017, correct? So. As of now, maybe we can invite our friends to prepare for the 2017 Regional Inventions Contest and Exhibit. So we will be going for more than 42 entries. At this point, ladies and gentlemen, let me call in the Director of DOST Technology Application and Promotion Institute to give us a message.
To everyone. I better read my message so that I won't be able to forget exactly, because when I ad-lib, sometimes the most important thing, sometimes I miss that. So I beg your indulgence. So first of all, let me greet you, good morning, and I want to thank already immediately the people behind this regional invention contest, spearheaded by the regional director of Region 7, DOST Region 7, Engineer Edilberto Paradela, who is also celebrating his birthday today. Happy birthday! And of course, without the help of the CCI, headed by its president, Ms. Teresa Chan, and of course, the ABLIC partner, and with the support, and actually, the person behind the inclusion of regional invention contest to the CCI activity is Mr. Francis D. With the support also of Ms. Elena here, they are also the board of directors of CCI. Thank you very much. Now, inventions are considered vital and necessary in accelerating and sustaining our country's economic growth. The active participation of the sectors of technology producers, that is the researchers, innovators, and inventors, is one of the important segments of the nation's progress. We at the DOST TAPI continue to give importance to the role of their play by our researchers, innovators, and inventors. By virtue of the Republic Act 7459, also known as the Inventors and Invention Incentives Act of the Philippines, We are also giving a lot of programs of assistance that would actually support the capability to produce the intellectual properties from these researchers, inventors, and innovators. If you will notice, the intellectual properties or the IPs that you are generating contributes to the growth of our, probably to the competitiveness of the industry. I would just like to inspire those who participated in this particular event. In 2010 to 2011, if you will notice, there is what you call an international or global measures that would rank each country in terms of competitiveness. And since we are looking forward to the global competitiveness, that's the most important thing I would just like to cite. The Global Competitive Index has actually 12 pillars, meaning to say it is measured in terms of business, other, etc. And one of the pillars is innovations. And one way to measure the innovation index is by means of the number of patents filed in a specific country. So it means to say that your contributions in terms of IP filings, in one way or another, helps the innovation index and eventually contribute to the 12 pillars. I would just like to cite you the performance of the Philippines in 2010 to 2011. The Global Competitive Index is actually measured on the last third quarter of the previous years to the first quarter of the current year. Like for example, 2010 to 2011, then 2011 to 2012. So between 2010 to 2011, the ranking of the Philippines is somewhere 85th out of 144 countries, I guess. In 2011 to 2012, with the massive promotions that we are doing, we increased our ranking. From 85, we became 75, 10 notch. So 2011 to 2012. In 2012 to 2013, again, we increased by 10 notch. We became 65 out of 144 countries. Then in 2012 to 2013, you know where we are? We became 59. And do you know where we are now standing from 2014 to 2015? We became 52nd already, out of 104. So that's a very big leap, right? And you will notice it was reported among the 144 countries measured in terms of competitiveness, the Philippines is the fastest among the countries in terms of improving their competitiveness. Of course, our ranking definitely is a little lower compared to the other ASEAN because of their status in other parameters or other pillars. But at any rate, it was recognized that the Philippines is actually leaping to improve their competitiveness. So this is the one, and this is also the real measures of how patents or patents filed in a specific country contributes to the Global Competitive Index. So we will still continue by virtue of the law of the Republic of 7459. TAPI will always continue to support all researchers, inventors, and innovators in terms of their IP protection, up to the stage of their prayer or even to the commercialization of their inventions and innovations. So I encourage, and that's why also for this year, as I have mentioned during the opening, okay, I have to already add it because I have mentioned already the most important thing. We will now actually provide all the necessary supports to the creative researchers who are potentials for IPs. Of course, those in the category of UM, industrial design, and patents, they have already their IPs. So those who do not have the IPs are the creative researchers. So all the entries now under creative research, and even for the CBOL, because they are still, the creative research, by the way, are for the professional ones. Okay? And the CBOL is actually a creative research for college students. college and high school students. So it means to say that even students now can contribute. So that's a way also of helping improving our global competitive index. When we say helping them to IP protect, to protect their IPs, we will provide the necessary financial assistance for the patent applications. We will provide the professional fees for hiring a patent agent. So it means to say the only contribution she will do is your full cooperation to the patent agents who will be assigned to you to disclose your innovation so that that will be well protected in terms of the patent claims that you will be filing in the intellectual property office. So for now, that's the problem now of TAPI. With the bulk of these researchers, we have to hire more patent agents. And the innovation done by TAPI for this particular way of improving the number of filings is we have already outsourced our patent agents from a group of private patent agents, meaning to say that aside from the patent agents of the Department of Science and Technology, we have also a pool of patent agents from the private sectors. So meaning to say that wala na pong problema, hindi na po magkakaroon ng backlog ang TAPI, no? So yun po. Now with that, so let's pray and continue for the winners of this particular contest. The first prize winners are later on will be explained later on by our panel judges. Will be the finalists for next year National Invention Contest. That's the reason why on 2017 there will be another Regional Invention Contest for us to select who will be the finalists for 2018. It's a venial activity. Before I end, I don't want to forget also to thank our panel of judges headed by Dr. Araceli Almase, who is a former regional director, and to our other members. They will be properly introduced later, so I don't have to to introduce them one by one. So with that, I would like to thank you all for participating in our activities, and see you in Manila for the National Invention Contest. Manila.
Thank you very much, Director Garcia. Indeed, what you have just said, sir, is a very good news for our researchers and inventors, especially that TAPI will be helping in facilitating the patents and protections for their researches. So to continue, let me call in the chair of the screening committee for the Regional Invention Contest and Exhibits. He is also from the UST7. And to introduce the board of judges, Mr. Brian B. Ibanez.
Once again,
good morning.
I know you're all excited, especially the students, to know the winners for this contest. But before that, I would like to introduce to you our distinguished panel of judges. So our first judge is presently the Dean, College of Engineering at the University of San Jose Recoletas. Since 2011, he's a magna cum laude graduate of Bachelor of Science in Chemical Engineering at the Cebu Institute of Technology. He's scholar and graduated Master's of Science in Metallurgical Engineering at the University of the Philippines. He's also a university scholar and finished Doctor of Philosophy in Material Science and Engineering at the University of the Philippines. He is also a former professor of the University of San Carlos, Cebu Institute of Technology, and Iligan Institute of Technology, where he conducted lectures on material science and engineering and subjects for a master's degree program for these subjects, polymer engineering, metallurgical engineering, respectively. He is also a former consultant of these companies, Global Steel International, Iligan City, Blast Furnace Plant, Treasure Steel Corporation, Iligan City, copper recovery processes of Syntec Incorporated, Iligan City, Material Science and Engineering, Timex Philippines, Lapu-Lapu City. And he published papers that received awards such as the Most Outstanding Thesis of the Year by the University of the Philippines Alumni Association and Best Technical Paper Award during the 39th Southeast Asia Iron and Steel Institute held in Malaysia. Help me welcome Dr. Virgilio Y. Abellana. He's presently the Dean, College of Engineering and Architecture of the Cebu Institute of Technology University. And he's a former Dean, Graduate School of Engineering and College of Engineering, University of San Jose Recoletas. And he completed numerous postgraduate studies and degrees in the same university, including or completing Magna Cum Laude Graduate Bachelor of Science in Chemical Engineering, Graduate of Bachelor of Science in Industrial Engineering, Graduate Master in Management for Executives and Managers, Graduate Master in Management Engineering, and Graduate Doctor in Management Major in Human Resource Management at the University of San Jose Recoletas. She is the founding director of the Philippine Institute of Industrial Engineers, Cebu Chapter, and a member, Philippine Institute for Chemical Engineers. She is also an assessor, zonal assessor of ICQUAM CHED. She's an accreditor, Philippine Association of Accredited Schools, Colleges and Universities, or PAASCO, an evaluator of the Philippine Non-Government Certification, or PCNC. Help me welcome Dr. Evangeline C. Evangelista. And of course, last but not the least, our third judge holds a Doctor of Philosophy in Education, specializing in in-service science teacher training from the Michigan State University in East Lansing, Michigan, USA. She holds a Master of Education, specializing in science curriculum analysis and development from the UP Cebu and Diliman, Quezon City. She also holds a Master of Science in Botany, specializing in freshwater phytoplankton systematics and ecology from the UP Diliman, Quezon City. And her bachelor degree is in pharmacy from the University of San Carlos, Cebu City. She is married to a lawyer and proudly having two children who are also both lawyers. She received various honors and grants, and one of them is the Fulbright Hayes Scholarship Grant for PhD specializing in science education. She also received a Ford Foundation of the Philippines research grantee for a PhD dissertation. She is a college scholar for 3 semesters from the University of the Philippines Cebu College, and a university scholar, UP Diliman, for a Master of Science in Botany degree. She started her career in 1958 to 1959 as a science research assistant of the National Research Council of the Philippines, or NRCP. She taught in various colleges and universities in Cebu as either a professor, lecturer, or as a college dean, until she became the first regional director of the newly established National Science Development Board in Region 7. And she retired a couple of years ago to establish a realty firm of her own. Help me welcome the chairman of the board, the chair of the board of judges, no? Dr. Araceli Gonzalez Almase.
very much, Mr. Ibanez. I would like to request Engineer Paradella, Director Garcia, Mr. D, Engineer Zamora, Mr. Espileta, and Ms. Chan to assist in giving the certificates of appreciation to our Board of Judges. Let me read the citation. The Department of Science and Technology, Regional Office Number 7, and Technology Application and Promotion, Dr. Virgilio Y. Abeliana, for being one of the judges during the 2015 DOST 7 Regional Invention Contests and Exhibits, June 18 to 2015, Cebu City Marriott Hotel, given this 20th day of June 2015 at Cebu City Marriott Hotel, Cebu, signed by Engineer Edelberto L. Paradella, Regional Director DOST 7, and Director Edgar Garcia Tapi DOST. We would also like to give the same certificate of appreciation to Dr. Evangeline C. Evangelista. The same certificate of appreciation is given to Dr. Araceli Gonzalez Almase. Criteria for judging. Let me call on Dr. Araceli Almase, the chair of the Board of Judges.
Creativity or methodology, 35%. Market potential, 30%. presentation and demonstration 10%. These were the categories that we had gone over and then scored for each participant. Peers we have observed, I have seen it from the very beginning. The research is presented, help improve. But you can see that we still need to improve. For those of you who are participants now, your participation is much better than in the preceding years. But try to keep up today with what is needed, especially by our region. This, remember, is a regional contest. And whatever benefits you may come up with, we would be the first to benefit from it. I think I've gone over what I was supposed to read to you, the criteria for judging, and this is what we have done the last 3 days. May I call on my co-judges? Okay, later. They will be recognized. So that I think is similar to that. There are two categories of student creative research. The college, again, originality, creativity, and methodology, participation, presentation, and demonstration is what we are focusing on. And when you go to remember this, whether you will be professional and you will participate in the professional category. The high school. The high school started very well with originality, creativity, but not yet for market potential. You're in high school yet. So probably when you will be in college, you'll be able to sell the inventions. The presentation and demonstration 100%. So I think that's as far as I have to present to you this.
Thank you very much, Dr. Almase. Before we will proceed to the announcement of the winners and runners-up, allow me to give the certificate of appreciation also to our non-competing exhibitors. We have with us Nature's Legacy. We also have European Chamber of Commerce of the Philippines and Power Measurements Incorporated. Are they with us this morning? Again, may I request our director, Director Paradella, Director Garcia, Mr. D, Engineer Zamora, Mr. Espelita, and Ms. Chan to give our certificate of appreciation to our non-competing exhibitors. Okay, so they are not with us. Sir, just remain standing na lang because we will be giving our awards, okay? A cash incentive and certificate of recognition. So allow me to announce the winners. So are you ready, participants and our inventors? Gikulbaan na mo karon? Sige, ato ni patrilling kamay. Okay, for the first category, we have the Siebel Award Student Creative Research for High School. Kinsa kaha ang atong second runner-up? The title of the student research is... wala tayo sound effects. Para mas thrilling daw siya. Okay, we have morphological characteristics of microbes with potential oil degrading ability. Researchers Pamela Jude M. Gonzalez with the advisor Miss Irene P. Lopez. They will be receiving 5,000 pesos and a certificate of recognition. Congratulations to our second runner-up. The title of the student research is Synthesis of Polyurethane from Coconut Oil. The researcher, John Nico Sueldo. We have Jadit Singh. Ayan Kenneth Buka with their advisor, Mr. Victor P. Mangkaw from Naga National High School of Cebu. They will be receiving 10,000 pesos. Final winner for the Student Creative Research for High School, who would be receiving 20,000 pesos and a certificate of recognition, is given to the Human Locomotion Vibration Energy Harvester prototype for powering light emitting diode with the researcher Risha Clapel M. Ferraren, Peter Gabriel A. Muania, with the advisor Benito A. Bahe from Philippine Science High School Central Visayas Campus Argao, Cebu. The Student Creative Research for College. For second runner-up, who would also be receiving 5,000 pesos and a certificate of recognition. Second runner-up with the title of the student research, Optimized Solar Collector and Tracker with Planar Reflector, researcher Michaela B. Alingana, John Vincent L. Tiansing, Dear friends, A. Ikot, and their advisor, Engineer Junjun A. Obispo, and Engineer Rachel M. Chong from Cebu Institute of Technology University. Congratulations. For our first runner-up for the Sea Boulevard College category, we have title of student research. This is first runner-up, Amphibious Tricica. Name of researchers, Jesse Pastor Bando, Ken Edward Mirasol, Henry Palamitos with their advisor, Dr. Roland M. Wu. They will be receiving 10,000 pesos cash and certificate of recognition.
Oh,
And for the regional winner for the Civil Award College category, we have title of student research, remote solar powered rainfall monitoring and alarm system, with the researchers Nick Jonathan B. Gandionco, Earl Andre A. Marnopia, Marvin A. Sumalino, Charles Ray B. Verdazzo, with their advisors Engineer Susana A. Tan, Dr. Rachel M. Chong of Cebu Institute of Technology University. Congratulations! We would like to acknowledge the presence of Dr. Rosine Ancheta Jr., the president from Cebu Technological University. Okay, let's proceed to the next category, the Likha Award Creative Research. For our second runner-up, who will be receiving a cash award of 5,000 pesos and certificate of recognition. Second runner-up is given to the title of research, Isolation Treatment System, Isobaring, with the researcher Jeselito B. Bari from Manila, Cebu City. Congratulations, sir. For our first runner-up, title of research, Power Booster and Fuel Saver Device by Mr. Joselito Arenas. He will be receiving 10,000 pesos cash and certificate of recognition. And the regional winner for creative research, the title of research, Gamomot Cylinderless Pneumatic Press by Engineer Noro S. Gamomot from Consolacion, Cebu. Congratulations, sir. You will be receiving 20,000 pesos cash and a certificate of recognition. So congratulations to our winners for the Likha Award for Creative Research. Okay, we still have another category, Outstanding Utility Model. For our second runner-up, the title of the invention is Method and Composition of Preparing Drawing Ink from Squid, Tyson Petty's Rhombus Pigment. The inventors Pedro P. Quizon, Bonifacio S. Villanueva, and Marshall B. Sosa. They will be receiving 5,000 pesos in cash and certificate of recognition. For our first runner-up, the title of the invention is Process and Composition in the Production of Milkfish Chanus Bone. Dr. Renisa Peñones from Cebu City. She will be receiving 10,000 pesos in cash as well. They will be receiving a 25,000 pesos in cash. The winner is with invention title Compact Diesel Brewer. The inventors Ralph A. Cabrera from Talamban, Cebu City, Romeo Disney Saison from Mabolo, Cebu City. Industrial design. We have our regional winner. He will be receiving 25,000 pesos. Title of invention: Theo Cocktail Table. With the inventor Vito Angelo D. Selma from Manila, Cebu. Congratulations. For our last category, the Tuklas Award or the Outstanding Invention, who will be receiving 50,000 pesos in cash. The winner with the title of invention, Mammoth Coffee Table, Radica Panels and Planter by Engineer Ramir D. Bonghanoy from Ming Lamilia, Cebu. Congratulations, sir. Thank you. all our winners. And let me announce that all regional winners are all still high. Okay, you have all received your big checks. Don't worry, you will receive the actual checks. Ilang kabalong ganun sa? Ipaniyo na ba yung cash karon? Okay, Saturday manta. Sige. So for our closing remarks, let me call in the Assistant Regional Director for Technical Services Division of the Department of Science and Technology Region 7. We have with us Engineer Jesus F. Zamora Jr. Okay.
Maraming excited katano kung nakadawat sa award pero katungwa sila Mr. Isa Chan, Mr. Donoy Espirita, Mr. Francis B, Director Ika Garcia, my boss, Engineer Paradela. Good morning. Yeah, it is my pleasure to provide the closing remarks on this very successful event. In behalf of the DOST 7, we would like to thank TAPI, represented here by Director Garcia and Hilda Silda, for sponsoring RISE. RISE is the Regional Invention Contest and Exhibit. RISE lang siya. Okay, nung dumdum kita ng RISE, hindi mo muna itong ikaw. Sponsoring RISE, thereby providing an avenue to showcase the inventive capability of the students, all the inventors here in Region 7. No? We'd like also to thank their partner, the Cebu Chamber of Commerce and Industry, for believing in the UST as a partner. No? Bisan o daghan kayo may o mga, we have some shortcomings, you know, I know. Just like any government agency, but you still believe in us. Siguro, nadas ang charm ni Sir Ed. The people from the Science and Technology Information Institute, ibiya ano mo sa inyong boss, but you still here, you still have to document us. Our inventors, researchers, and exhibitors, for without you, there will be no RISE, no? Why exhibitors? Magkonsama ng space, no? And to our valued judges, especially sa among regional director before, who is still very, I don't know, very active po kay si Ma'am. Who worked overtime to evaluate the winners. To the winners of this contest, congratulations. Please spend the money wisely. And to those who were not able to make it, your time will come. No? Continue to just participate in the exhibit. Anyway, you are already a winner. Just being a participant or an exhibitor to the RISE was already a contest itself. No? Kay, you know, Mr. Brian Ibanez is very strict. No? He was the one who was in charge of the screening of the participants. And if we have to admit all the exhibitors to those participants, the ballroom of Marriott is not enough. So iyan i-trim down to 42. Katungwa maka-appeal. That's the fault of Mr. Ibanez. So panghihaanin din si Mr. Ibanez, those who were not able to participate. No? So kadaghan sa iyang screen, wag ito si Tugtog, no? So, you are already a winner being a part of this activity. So, what's next? Our previous winner, si Pete Dilantar, was able to make it to the international competition. We hope that another one from Cebu would also make it again, no? It brings pride to the Cebuanos and to the region itself, no? To have winners. And maybe next time, continue your inventive inventive thinking. You may call it crazy thinking because good things come from crazy ideas, no? So what I'm about, so now we do not think of it before, but crazy people think of it, and it is now here, no? So continue that, and spend your winning wisely. Thank you, and good morning.
Guests here with us, and to all the participants and our visitors, we will be seeing you in 2 years' time for the 2017 Regional Inventions Contest and Exhibits, but for the regional winners, they will be participating next year for the National Inventions Contest and Exhibits. But definitely, we will be seeing you for the next DOST programs and events, since we will definitely be having a lot. So this will be the end of this morning's program. Have a blessed day and good morning.